everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue the intrigue here in the Binding of Isaac Invicta Afterbirth Plus series. Merry Christmas, happy holidays, everybody out there. And as you can see, the like streak has indeed hit 100. Now, a couple of you will notice that the last time that we had the like streak count up there was 98 because we were waiting for the 24 hours for the previous episode. And in that 24 hours, not only did the previous episode hit 1,000 likes, but the one after it also did. So I said, you know what, let's count it as 100 because this was the original day that the streak was supposed to hit 100 anyway, and it just worked out beautifully. So theoretically, what I'm going to do today is going to be our victory lap run. Now, before you get worried, I am planning on going through here and completing the victory streak if our run is good enough. I'm going to try to make it as good as possible. I know that I said that I would do 100 victory lap on the 100 like streak, but something else that I need to address, well, let me get to the seed really quickly. Your seed day is going to be Papa Echo, November Charlie, 9 Foxtrot, Mike Sierra. We also have growth. No, we have Roid Rage and Compost. Decent damage, good tears rate, great movement speed at the start. Also have the Golden Horseshoe for the trinket. Now, that thing I need to address. When I said that we would do 100 like streak or 100 victory laps, I completely forgot that you turn into the Lost after the third streak, after the third lap. So I don't know if we're going to be able to do 100 laps in today. I don't even know if this run is going to be worthy of doing a victory lap. I mean, who freaking knows? We're going to try to make it work, though. This is what my plan is. What I plan on doing is going for as long as possible, realistically. but if we start balling out of control, which, I mean, this is a good start. We don't have any premier item, but our stats are pretty decent at the start. I think that, who knows? Maybe we'll get a really overpowered Lost run. We'll have, like, Brimstone, Mom's Knife, or whatever. And we'll just go ham. We'll just run the table. So I've never the highest victory lap I've ever done, I think, was 2. I did try a third victory lap. This is a long time ago, and that's when I discovered that actually you do turn into the Lost on lap 3. Which of course I'm going to keep the streak alive. I'm not going to make. Ooh, that's a good start too. I'm not going to take any advantage. I'm going to take every advantage possible to keep going. We need to get as strong as possible if this is going to be the episode that we're going to do this on. And honestly, I'm kind of encouraged right now because Jacob's Ladder is going to be very, very nice. Now, for those of you wondering what a victory lap is where you go straight to the Lamb. And essentially what happens is after you beat the Lamb, you get the option to do a victory lap, which means that you can continue your run and basically just start from scratch. So you restart the run, you lose a couple of items, and then subsequently you'll start losing even more items as the victory lap progresses. You can get repeat items, that sort of thing. But the thing about victory laps is that you can also get stronger during them. Especially if you retain a lot of your good items, you'll get even more decent items. And of course, you'll be getting more double deals, more everything that you ever wanted. So victory laps can be very strong in a sense, but of course, keep in mind that once you turn into the Lost, you got to be a little careful. Because yes, you do turn into the Lost. I don't believe that the transformation from going from Eden to the Lost gives you the Holy Mantle. I'm pretty sure it doesn't. Wow, I'm actually really surprised it's not there. We should go look into the cursed room here. Again, I'm going to be doing everything I can to make this run as powerful as possible. Because the streak is on the line. This is not like the Mosh Pit Twitch save file. This is the streak. I'm very excited. Hope everyone had a great Christmas and happy holidays. I hope you all got the gifts that you wanted. And maybe if you didn't want any gifts, then I hope you gave all the good gifts that you wanted to give out. I always enjoy giving gifts more than I do receiving them. I've never been a big fan of getting gifts. I mean, of course, it's nice as a kid. You're like, oh, I wish I had my Nintendo 64, you know, or I wish I had my PlayStation or whatever have you. You know, no one really, I don't think any kids ask for, like, toy train sets anymore. Unless they have one of those really, like, expensive but awesome motorized ones that travel like an actual train set, and those are pretty cool indeed. Wow, lots of soul hearts. I'm going to walk in here. Normally, I wouldn't be going in here without a bomb. We get Horror Babylon and Brother Bobby. Now, how hard do we want to go on this demon judgment? The answer is pretty hard. Not too ham, though. We have to remember we are coming out of a cursed room. We get Incubus, or Succubus, rather. I am going to take Horror of Babylon, of course. Horror of Babylon is going to give us a massive advantage here as far as our stats are concerned early on, especially combined with the fact that we are going to have the golden, or not the golden horseshoe, but Jacob's Ladder. I was looking at the golden horseshoe as I was saying that. Jacob's Ladder is going to be a huge benefit. So we're all, this is a good start. If we were going to have a very strong, oh man, did we even get the Book of Sin? Hello, how you doing? If we wanted a good start to possibly start running some victory laps on, this is a good base to start with. Now, are we going to get 100 victory laps out of this? I don't know. let's keep everything in perspective. I do want the 9-volt for the Book of Sin. That'd be nice. Book of Sin coming up. This was recorded on a different day, by the way. I'm recording this on Christmas Eve. There we go. So we're going to be able to get the 9-volt, which is going to give us a much quicker charge of the Book of Sin, even though it's a little bit of a waste for that. We could have done that after I fought the boss. I'm not that worried about it. Monstro is going to have absolutely no chance of killing us whatsoever. So is 100 victory laps possible? I'm sure it is. I don't know how many items they start taking away from you eventually there. Now here's the bad thing about having Horror of Babylon as Isaac. I want to keep Horror of Babylon, and normally I wouldn't even go take Brother Bobby, but I want to make it clear that I want to keep the Horror of Babylon transformation. Curse of Lost, hooray. And the Horror of Babylon transformation, unless if you're Eve. We have to be real careful here. Unless if you're Eve, Horror of Babylon transformation only happens when Isaac has one half of a red heart or less. And currently we have less than half of a red heart because we have zero. Now the left hand is also very, very interesting here. Is the left hand better? Is the left hand better than the golden horseshoe? The thing about the golden horseshoe, which is so nice, it's also a very weird spot in the boss room. Let's hold off on that. Let's slow our roll. The thing that's nice about the Golden Horseshoe is that it can give you a double item room, meaning that there's going to be two items in one room, and you have the ability to choose which item that you want. The left hand, however, almost guarantees that we get more Devil Deals, Soul Hearts, and even, of course, a large chance of getting a Guppy item. Yeah, Kane's Other Eye, that pretty much makes the choice for me here. The only thing of that... We can get this. The only thing that I don't like about the Golden Horseshoe, which I guess I can't really hold against it because like it's giving it to you for free, it's just that the proc rate is very low, and I mean very low. If we're doing a victory lap, if we are doing the 100 victory lap run, we've got to get Guppy. We have to get everything. I mean, we got to be balling out of control. So I am going to go back and go pick up the left hand. This will turn all chests into basically dark chests, including this one. This is a mob trap room, okay. Yeah, there we go. That was worth it. So, what are we looking for right now? We're basically looking for damage. Flying, of course, would be nice. With Horror of Babylon, you already have a solid base damage to work with. I mean, Hollow is not going to enjoy this. I would love to get tech. If we can get tech 10, that'd be awesome. Guppy's Hairball, okay. We pretty much have to take this. Again, given the fact that we have the left hand, any Guppy item that we get is going to be a huge boost. And we'll head on down to the next floor. I have a very special Christmas episode of a particular series just starting up that you all may enjoy. It's going to be one of those things where if you want to see more of this, let me know by leaving a comment, liking, all that kind of good stuff. Ansa's Merry Christmas to me. Wouldn't it be the perfect Christmas present if we were able to get an overpowered run here on Christmas Day and we end up doing like 100 victory laps? I don't know if doing 100 victory laps is even possible. I truly do not know. But if it is, I'm going to try my best on this run. Because I think that this run is actually powerful enough to handle it. Not right now, of course, but again, we have a solid base here. Let's go to the item room first. We need bombs. I really want to get... jumper cables are not necessary, but they... With the Book of Sin, what's nice about that is that you'll essentially be able to get HP while fighting enemies that spawn a lot of mobs. So what the jumper cables do, the jumper cables, easy for me to say, are a passive item that allows you to get a charge on your spacebar item every time you kill a certain amount of enemies. Gonna pick this up so it doesn't show up again. Now we have a dice room here. We also have an arcade. The arcade could help us make enough money to get jumper cables. Okay. Still would... Not exactly sure what hit me there. I think maybe the statue hit me. Get a Yara rune, alright. Ooh. Yeah, we gotta. We gotsta. Alright, so what are we looking for in here? If any of these chests have an item in it, we're happy. We're not happy. We're like semi-happy. We're not happy. All right, well, unfortunately we're not happy, although we did get a bomb thanks to the Book of Sin, as well as 9-volt for giving us that reduced charge time. But as you're seeing here, Horror of Babylon plus Jacob's Ladder just melts everything that we've got early on. Remember, this is just the early game. We're just getting started. This is we're already on floor 4. So we're doing okay. Take the pills, Invicta, take the pills. No, thank you. I'm disinclined to acquiesce your request. Let's see what's in here. Global D20 would be awesome. D1, or D4 rather, no thank you. I'm gonna take a risk and go for the super secret room first. It's a risk because the secret room usually gives us money. And we get an Eternal Heart, which I will take, even though that ruins Horror of Babylon temporarily for us on the next floor. I have a feeling that we're going to be able to get more devil deals thanks to having the left hand. The left hand was absolutely the right play there. Get one of our keys back. We're really hoping for a bomb, though. I'm putting a lot of emphasis on us getting jumper cables because we're going to need the Book of Sin. Hearthrow rune, okay. Donation machine. We don't really need to put anything. We're going to need the donation machine. All right, let's finish off this floor here and let's see what we got. Now we could buy that bomb, but that's a little counterintuitive. If the object for us is to buy something, we don't need to buy something that we don't want. There we go. So we get a bomb that's going to allow us to get into the regular secret room. Our movement speed's a little bit too high for my liking, but I'd rather have fast movement speed than not. The no movement speed. It's more Yaves, which is not what we want at all. We could go use that Perthro rune on the D12. I'm not gonna do that. Hangman. Hangman doesn't really help us here. But thank goodness we have this movement speed, man. No. Although I could Perthro rune that. I could Perthro that, and that would be very, very good because that's actually gonna be tapping into the dark chest loot instead of like the normal boss loot. For pedestals. Although I think I needed to re-roll it before I exited. No, it's still on the dark chest. Let's see what we get off of Rag Mega first. I'm hoping it's something like Magic Mush. I would take Mom's Knife. Hey, if we're doing a huge victory lap run, then all bets are off. We're taking what we can get. Mr. Mega, I will take Mr. Mega. And Mr. Mega will allow us to not only get the jumper cables, but it'll also allow us to access that donation machine. So we can indeed afford the jumper cables. And I know that some people are probably thinking, like, you know, come on, you don't really, like, our jump cable is really that good. They are if you have the right space for item, in my opinion. Or I could get rid of some HP here. Yeah, I'd rather not ding our donation machine, because we're going to need the bombs on the next floor anyway. That's fine. So we give a soul heart and a half to get jumper cables. I think that's worth it. I might as well use a bomb here. Okay. All right. So, but we're very good off right now. We have the damage to sustain us for quite a long time, especially thanks to the fact that we have Pentagram. We need, if we can somehow manage to get, yeah, see, even without Horde Babylon, our damage is still okay. If we can manage to get a hard carry item like Maw of the Void, I really want Tech 10. We haven't had Tech 10 in a long time. HP there we go. Aldous Rune, okay. Hopefully we run into a donation machine or blood bank or something like that. Oh man, you'll assuredly you'll be able to know how we do on a victory lap run here by just looking at the at the runtime here. It's gonna be High Priestess, and I don't want that. So we can use the Aldous Rune in here. We get Inner Eye, which is actually not bad for us, especially if we have Jacob's Ladder, which of course we do. I'm actually gonna use the Aldous Rune here. You might think that's a little bit of a waste, which it could be, but if that chest had paid out with something good, then you know it would have looked like a little bit better. And yes, I should have looked at the rest of the floor before even doing that, but eh, ain't worried about it. We're very ahead of the curve right now. Jacob's Ladder is huge. Yeah, we need to do this. Get Guppy's Tail. That's our second Guppy item, and we even get Krampus out of the way here. Yeah, we're firing on all cylinders right now. So unfortunately, we don't get to skip this because we didn't pick up Guppy's Tail before this room resolved. So we're still going to have to fight this mob trap room, which is unfortunate, but not that big of a deal. So we get our second Guppy item. I would love to have a little bit of a higher base damage. Tears rate, of course, is always going to be an issue. And we get Guppy. Wow. Is this the urn? Is this the urn? It's a good start. We go back to being Horde Babylon. And we get Guppy on floor 5. It's happening. We've got the Ansa's Rune here. Guppy, of course, is going to turn us into Guppy. And give us the ability to spawn fly. Is basically what's so great about having Guppy is that A, you get flying, B, you also get the benefit of having the mulligan effect, which basically spawns attack flies every time that you hit an enemy. Like rune here. We'll get another AWAS, alright. So I'm gonna hold on to my Ansa's. Now, the real question is, do we continue to hold on to the left hand? Honestly, I think the answer is no at this point. The left hand did everything that we needed it to. The only reason why, if you recall, the only reason why that I even wanted the left hand was so we can get a Guppy chance, and we were able to do that. Now, what I will say is that the left hand does facilitate more devil deals later on. So do we have to hold on to the left hand right now? We don't have to. Should we? It's up for debate. I mean, you could certainly argue the fact that, well, if we keep the left hand, then we're basically ruling out the possibility of us getting, like, say, Cricket's Head or Steven or something like that. And who's to say that we won't see it again? Yeah, so we don't need anything in there. We need to go to the item room, just making sure. Yeah, this is... We are A-okay right now, Isaac. Got a Justice card, might as well use that. Gonna be a blank rune. Maybe we'll get Perthro. Maybe we'll get lucky. I don't want the speed upgrade. Perthro. It was a Perthro rune, and we get Banky. Wow. It must be my birthmas. Quite literally, it must be my birthmas. Head on down to the next floor. If you hear the pitter-patter or barking of dogs or stuff like that, it's because, again, we have family over. Wow. So not only do we get Guppy when I, like, was clearly gunning for, we also end up getting a random blank rune that turns into Purrthro, and then it gives us a Tears upgrade. I almost feel like something's going on here. I guess Santa just wants to see, he wants to deliver this present to everyone as well. You know what? I want to be the one to deliver it to you all. I mean, I'm not calling myself Santa. I wouldn't be so presumptuous, but, you know. I think that if I could play Santa, oh my goodness. We even get Dead Cat. Well, we pretty much have to go for it. This is the run. This is the run. And we even get Guppy's head. I think we stick with Guppy's head, to be honest. I mean, the Book of Sin's nice, but when we can recharge Guppy's head over and over again, thanks to the jumper cables, that's real good damage. Man, I don't think I've seen a run get set this fast, this quickly in a long time. Yeah, it's blessed by Christmas, even though this wasn't recorded on Christmas. Even get the compass so we don't have to worry too much about the Invicta navigational errors here. Okay, we get another black rune, that's fine. I do want to use this blank rune. Taurus for the lost would be pretty good. But you can't shoot with Taurus. I'm gonna pass on that. Yeah, I'm gonna pass on that. Here's the reason why. I think that we're going to have enough damage to stay safe in almost any situation as a lost. I'm not going to skip directly to the dark room right now because we do have a lot of damage, but we don't have enough for me to feel comfortable yet. So I think what we do is we go, like, we'll be back. Like, I'm not worried about that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use this black rune and use it on boss rush. And I'm going to consume the boss rush items unless, I almost completely screwed that up. Unless if we find something that's just amazing. Oh, God. Man, do we take soy milk? We already have Guppy. Our damage is going to get shot straight down. But the thing I worry about with soy milk is we don't have piercing right now, and that could prove problematic with the lost. However, we're already Guppy. So I don't know if this is the right call or not. If some of you remember that very good episode and very watched episode that I had a couple months ago, Sinvicta's favorite soy milk run ever, you'll recall that I do tend to favor soy milk in situations where if we have a lot of good tier effects stacked on top of each other, it can be extremely powerful. And given the fact that we've got we have Inner Eye on top of Jacob's Ladder, I think that we're much stronger this way. So here's the million-dollar question now. What item do we really want now that we have soy milk? Deadeye. Deadeye, and we want Deadeye, we want Death's Touch, and yeah, those are my two big wants here. Libra, of course, is going to be the ultimate prize. And here's an even bigger question for you. What happens if we find Juice's Shadow? You know, do we save Juice's Shadow for when we turn into the Lost and use that as our backup? I don't know. But I have never seen a run come together so quickly, so perfectly than this run. It's a magical time. This is a blessed run, to be sure. I really, really want piercing shots. Man, this is when you know something's up. This is when you know if Santa's really paying attention here for us. If we get Death's Touch and or Deadeye with it, before we go to our first victory lap, you'll know that this is truly blessed. Now, what I'm hoping for is an ability to port out of here. But, again, it's not that big of a deal because we are planning on coming back here. It's not that big a deal because we're planning on doing victory laps. So, missing out on our shops for now is not hugely detrimental. Hopefully, everyone who watches the Isaac series with the family, you're introducing Grandma and Grandpa to Isaac for the first time. Maybe you wanted to share, like, hey, I watched this big nerd on YouTube named Invicta. And maybe the old folks are like, well, why? Show them this run. I try to go above and beyond for y'all because a lot of you do the same for me. And again, I emphasize this is on the streak save file. So, you know, this is what I will say. If the streak ends today, if it ends because of the victory laps, honestly, I couldn't think of a better way to end the streak. Get the gauze. Just gonna use that right now. A lot of the items I'm gonna be taking are gonna be made very specifically with the understanding that we're going to become the Lost. Yeah, we get Pause. I don't want Pause. I'm going to reroll Pause right now. Mom's Pad. I'll just touch it to get it out of here. Go for another Perthrow rune. And we get Game Breaking Bug, which I actually don't want. And we get a Trapdoor. No Trapdoor. All right, so I'm going to hold on to the Black Rune because the Black Rune is actually huge for... The Black Rune is actually pretty huge for Soy Milk. Yeah, we'll use it now. All right, we got to luck up movement speed. I actually want a little bit more movement speed. It's going to be a little bit controversial whether or not I should have taken Taurus. You could certainly argue either way. But I mean, just look at this. Like, this is just this pure madness right now. I knew something was going on as soon as I saw Jacob's Ladder. It's like, okay, this is going to be good. You start with Jacob's Ladder, you're starting off with a lot of extra damage. What's this? Blank Rune. What we got? Degas. All right. All right. So I'm still holding on to the left hand, of course. And, all right. Well, I thought maybe... Surely it wouldn't be so straightforward here, but I guess it is.
Oh, even with the compass, Invicta still gets lost.
I'm not lost. It's just I'm looking which path is the right one. You know, I mean you're lost. I mean you made the wrong choice. Headless baby. I'm only taking this because I'm trying to get rid of our red hearts because I want to get back down to Horror Babylon. Now that we are in the Horror Babylon state, our damage is going to be even better. And you might be looking at this being a thing like, oh, your damage isn't that great. You have to remember how many times we're firing a second.
Agalaz.
Soy Milk, when you have Soy Milk firing off at this level of damage, it is a monstrous amount. You're talking about room clearing damage secondarily. Just due to your passive tier synergies. And that's very, very strong. Get our soul heart back. I appreciate that. Now, are we going to fight Hush? No. No. I don't want to complicate things by fighting extra bosses right now. Oh, okay, game. All right. You only get one of those today, game. This run doesn't belong to me. This belongs to the mosh pit. Get range of tears. I already know what was in there. Just double checking. Head on down, man. Oh man, this is we are cooking. We're cooking with bacon and fire and all kinds of crispy, crunchy goodness. I am not taking Curse of the Blinds under no circumstances. Under absolutely no circumstance will I ever be using taking Curse of the Blind. Not on this run. Because if we get Missing Node, that's just sad for everybody. Or Isaac Hearted as well. I cannot afford to do that. Hopefully you all understand. I have a feeling that I don't even need to say that because I know that people will understand. Except for the one guy who's like, oh, you play this way or my way or the highway, Invicta. Now I'm hoping that Rune Bag just bails us out and we get Degas. Okay. I'm a little bit suspicious there. With not one but two dark chests in a row. Ansa's, we'll hold on to that. Could one of them be the pack? Yes. Could one of them be 9 lives? I mean, it's possible. Stranger things have happened. Which is still not a show that I've seen yet. Okay, like, what's going on? 3 dark chests with items in it on Curse the Blind that I can't. I cannot take it. If it's Cursed Eye, we're sunk. Cursed Eye would be awful with this build. I can't do it. I can, but I won't. More likely than not, it's probably Cursed the Tower, the Pact, and then Cursed Eye. Something like that. And again, I'm not going to fight Hush. Not right now. I would need to get one of those premier items I was talking about, like Deadeye, Death's Touch, something like that, for me to feel truly comfortable in going after the optional bosses. It's Perthro. Again, kind of hoping that we get a Degas rune, which is the reason why I'm staying on this floor temporarily. But if we don't get him, we don't get him. Get ready for a long run. All right. We can't possibly... Again, there's nothing that we want in there. We don't need HP right now. I wish there existed a chance to find a machine that you could pay to lift a curse. Wouldn't that be neat? Like if they had a holy shrine or something like that, where you could put in either HP or you could donate just money, and it has a chance to clear the curse on your current floor. You know, and then a very small chance to give you like a permanent curse. I think that's very appropriate for Isaac. Tinted Rock in there, which I'll go get in a second. And taking Guppy's head was again the right call. Another curse chest. Look. If we get Cursed Eye, it ruins everything. I cannot risk getting Cursed Eye. I truly cannot. I can't do it. I know that's going to bum some people out. You're just going to have to be bummed out for now. Hopefully we'll get Black Candle. I did a full clear there because I was hoping that that rune bag would give us a Degas rune. It didn't quite happen. All right, so we have this Yara rune here, which I am going to use on the next floor. But, I mean... I love it when a plan comes together, that's for sure. Hopefully the family's like cheering and like, oh yeah, you know, we got it. Everything's coming together so perfectly. I don't feel guilty. I feel honored. Thank you, game. Thank you, Santa. And thank you all very much for supporting this series. I was gonna be mad if that was the Degas rune. Stanley doesn't stand a chance, but the real test doesn't get here until we turn into the Lost. It's already a done deal that we're gonna do a victory lap and just smoke everything for now. Even with this somewhat low damage that we have, we have great soy milk damage. I don't want to get it twisted. We have great soy milk damage, but it can be better. We don't have apocalyptic, cataclysmic damage yet. If we get Deadeye, if we get Death's Touch, something like that, then we're talking about truly scary damage. I'm hoping that we get to have a Libra appearance at some point during today. Alges. No thanks. I mean, I'll use it for the boss. Hello, Stanley. You're not gonna have a fun time today, Stanley. I can confidently say this is not your day today, Stan. Of all the days of the year, this is not the one for you, Stanley. Yeah, we really need something to ramp up our damage. I'm very happy that we had this Alges rune. We're going to go back and get that Yara rune real fast here. All right. So lap number one is about to go down. Can we get 2,000 likes if we do just a ton of victory laps? Let's make it possible. I don't think any of my videos have ever had more than that, except for the super fight video. We'll start with a paltry 2K likes, depending on how far we go. I don't think that's too greedy. It's in the spirit of things.
Oh, you gonna start keeping a like counter for 2,000 likes, Invicta?
No, I think I've already made my point about that. It seemed that the reaction from people was pretty much what I expected, which was everyone says that they're gonna. Mostly everyone said that they are going to support the channel no matter what. Some people definitely saw my point about not getting rid of the like counter because it does incentivize people to say, hey, by the way, if you really want to support not only my channel but any channel that you enjoy on YouTube, clicking the like button helps out more than you could ever know. And if you need a proof, just look at my channel. We have grown so much in the past 4 months than we have in the entire 11 years that my channel has been around. That's the God's honest truth. We have grown more in the last 4 months than I have in the last technically 6 years that I've been doing this full time. Answers. That is insane. And it's all thanks to the algorithm. And you don't get into the algorithm unless you have huge support from your fans. And liking is one of those big pillars of support. The other one is of course views, of course, but likes. Viewer engagement's way more important. Way more important. So you're seeing a little bit of our frailty right here. And it's something that we need to shape it up on. We need to bone up on a little bit here, Isaac. We can't be bleeding out damage right now because we don't have any way. Cuffy's collar. We don't have a good way of recreating HP for ourselves yet. Now I will say that if we had soy milk at the time that I had to choose between the Book of Sin and Guppy's head, I would not have taken Guppy's head because Guppy's head is basically useless now. Not useless, but it's not necessary now. All right, round one here against the lamb. That's right, we didn't take a damage there. We didn't take a damage. Take down the body here. Almost got flawless on the first run. Victory lap. Oh, you bet your bottom dollar game. Merry Christmas. Let's go. Got another Yara rune. Robo Baby. Not too high on, but I will take just to get it out of the way here. If you're wondering why that Curse of Darkness persisted, that was from us going into the Dark Room, and we get Hive Mind. Oh, man. Oh, my goodness. Now you're talking about some serious damage here with our flies. Answers. Hey, there we go. Hairthrow. You know what would be a great item for us to get? Would definitely be the D6. The D-Sizzle would be nice. Oh, Pin. Pin, don't even come out of here, Pin. Yeah. I'm going to take Red Heart HP because remember, we're going to be taking deals with the devil continually all the way through here. If we could get the treasure map from a shop, that would be nice, eventually. Piggy bank, okay. Now, on every victory lap, the game will start taking away stuff from you. So you get weaker the longer you go, but you can regain that strength if you get lucky enough to get the items back on the subsequent, well, the subsequent lap that you're on. I didn't see what that rune was. I think it was another Yara rune. We get jumper cables again, sure. Is that another Yara rune? Because if it is, it is. Wow. Yara rune's dropping like candy. Okay, so I'm gonna Yara this room.
Yara.
Let's see if this is a two of diamonds. I hope it is. It is ace of clubs. Do not want that. Alright, so we're gonna go back, we're gonna get that other Yara rune. There we go. Alright, and we have enough money for the next set of shops. We were able to reclaim jumper cables, which is great. Now, I don't know the exact order that the game takes away items in, but I do know that usually when you're doing a lot of victory laps, you see a lot of the same items that you saw before, because it's locked into the seed, obviously. Guppy's tail again. Happy to have that comboed with the left hand. AWAS, don't really care about AWAS. A lot of HP in here. I'd be happy to take that. Now, remember, we don't have Horror of Babylon active right now, either. So our damage is going to be a little bit better once we go get rid of this red heart and this devil deal here. Small rock. Small rock's going to get us back down to two-tier delay. Oh, my God. Look at this. Look at this damage. Soy freaking milk. And we get Eye of Belial. Now we're talking. Eye of Belial with soy milk is huge. Huge, huge, huge McHuge face right here. Now it's not exactly Deadeye, or Death's Touch, but it's good enough for now. Imagine if we get Magic Mush. Things are just falling into place on this run, and I don't even know what to think. Other than Merry Freaking Christmas. Humbling Bundle, I will take that. Humbling Bundle is going to turn all consumable drops into double drops. Don't really want Undefined. We can leave that there. I'm going to be rushing bosses here. We don't need to do a whole lot of extra exploration right now, because I want to get to the boss items. We get Binky again. We also get Black Rune. Binky's going to drop us back down to a one-tier delay. I can go back and get the Black Rune and use it on Undefined. Oh my goodness. This is... I never would have thought that this run, A, the timing would have worked out so perfectly, and B, we would have been doing it with soy milk. But in a weird way, it's weirdly... Yo, though, game. In a weird way, it's actually kind of poetic. We don't really need either of those. I mean, the shovel we could use, maybe, but... Eh. In a weird way, it's kind of poetic because of how well that soy milk video did. And it really reflects on how much success we've had on the channel this year. It's unprecedented. Bloody Crown would be nice. We already have the left hand, of course. Bloody Crown guarantees item rooms inside of the womb, but I think we've already proven the fact that the reason why you take the left hand is because you take the left hand. You want the double deals. You want the guppy items. Yes, it is possible for us to get even more nine lives, which would make me feel a lot better about turning into the Lost. Now, I do not believe that the game will take away extra lives from you. I don't think it can take away lives. I don't think, again.
No, you just don't think, Syndicta.
No, I don't think like you! Name that fake argument from a fantastic movie. Really, very underrated movie. I'll give you 5 seconds trying to name that movie. Bonus points if you can say who the actor who said it. Take the Perthrow rune here. Now would I take Mob's Knife or Brimstone with this run? No, absolutely not. Neither one of those items helps us. In fact, they both greatly hinder our progression here. And that was the movie Rounders, the line that was said by one Edward Norton to one Matt Damon. Matt Damon's character, Mike, is like, you don't think. And Edward Norton's character, Worm, says, no, I don't think like you. It's a great line. Great movie. If you're a poker fan, you've seen Rounders. Got another Yarrow rune, which is just getting this starting to get out of hand now. Look how many flies we have. Nod Leaf is good. That's gonna be very helpful with the loss in case we do actually get an orbital. We have no orbital right now outside of Guppy's Hairball. I don't really want the Eternal Heart. Oh, Chubb. Yeah, Chubb's dead. Oh, Chubberino. We end up getting Pentagram again. Dark Prince's Crown, I don't really want. Although I probably should have Perthrow that. I completely forgot we had Perthrow. You know what? I'm going to hold on to the Perthrow. We've seen so many Yarrow runes. What are we holding on to Yarrow runes for? We don't need anything. We just want more damage. We want more stats. Shard of Glass doesn't give you damage, I don't think. Yeah, it just gives you a range up when you take damage. I mean, we don't even have to move. It's a literal Christmas miracle of a run. I'm still like blown away with how well this run came together. I was unsure. I was like, okay, I need to make this work. Like, is the game gonna make it easier or gonna make it hard on me to do the victory lap run? And then here we are. Like, who's worried? Not me. Things won't get interesting until we turn into the Lost. That's when we have to start thinking about some serious change. Oh my goodness. Even get money equals power. Good lord, our damage with soy milk is gonna be bonkers. It's only going to get better, too. That's the best thing about this. It's only going to get better. All right, got a lot of bombs there. Happy about that. I mean, Death's Touch doesn't even matter. But Death's Touch is also huge for this because it can give you flat damage ups. And for Soy Milk, that's big time big. Black Candle. Good to see you, my old friend. More options. Now, what do we want? Would we take Chaos? We actually don't want... I do not want Tarot Cloth for this. Would we take Chaos? We gotta take Blank Card. I'm sorry, Guppy said. Blank Card Yera. We could get... I mean, we're going to get Blank Card Yera. Like, you just know what's gonna happen. We don't need Degas anymore. I mean, I think you gotta. No, we want something sexier than that. No. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Pandora's Box. What would that give us? We're on Dank Depths 1. 4 Soul Hearts. Yeah, you missed me with that. Basically, what I'm doing, I'm looking for Death's Touch or Deadeye. That holds the key to everything that we need. Because then I truly do believe that we can do 100 laps. And this is what I will say, because I didn't plan for us for this run to last that long. Screw you, little Gish. I didn't plan for this run to be the one that's going to be like 10 hours long. So what I may do is I may split up this recording into multiple runs. I'm not going to stop the run, of course. But the only reason why I may have to do this is because, like, I am recording this on Christmas Eve, and we've got like family plans and stuff. And while I do think that this is very, very, very strong, and this could very well be the 100 victory lap run, I don't realistically have the time to do the entire run right now. Per throw this, not gonna matter. We don't need Guppy's Paw. So this might be our first ever multi-part run. And I know that's gonna bend some people out of shape, but I also know that a majority of you out there will completely understand. Because again, I was not planning on this being the run. I thought that maybe we could do a couple of should I have taken Head of the Keeper there? I don't know. Because we have monkey equals power, and also money equals power. But I think I'd rather. Yeah, I don't want it. Get a Yarrow rune. Okay, so the Yarrow rune is there. Goat head is huge for this. I also want Sin Robes. I almost don't want Blank Card Yarrow. Like, we don't need it. We don't need Blank Card Yarrow rune. Oh man, Maul of the Void. Let's see if we can. We should at least try to get Maul of the Void. As silly as it sounds, I don't think we need Yarrow. We don't need Blank Card Yarrow. I am going to drop the left hand though, because now that we're in the realm of chaos, we don't need red chests anymore. The only thing we need red chests for would be like late game deal with the devils. Yeah, see, it's already started. Let's use the coupon here and let's see. There's a full charge up here. We could guarantee a free shop here. Let's think about this. I can use the Yarrow rune on the full charge, right? Yarrow. Okay, and then all we need is another full charge on the Yarrow rune, and then we're home free. Because then we can guarantee. Free shops in the free items in the shop without having to pay money, which is usually what free means. When we already have enough money to pay for Maw of the Void. But now, what am I doing? We don't even need to do this. Well, let's see if these are chests. Ooh. Okay. Okay. First let's take things down a notch here. Let's not get too excited. First things first, we need to make our energy bank. Yarrow. We have made the energy bank here. Okay, so now what we're going to do is let's go see what's inside of these golden chests. One more for good measure. If there's an item in these golden chests, that could be it, but I want to assure people that we don't need to be doing this. We're already strong enough. I just want to see if these are items. That one is not. That one is not. Okay. So I'm not going to worry about doubling these. Now, you could make an argument and say that, well, you should have at least doubled the money on the floor. Yes, that is true. But I ain't worried about it. Okay, so now with the coupon and all those full charges here, we can literally guarantee that we get everything. Oh, wow. We get Maw of the Void immediately. Is this the luckiest run in the history of everything here? For the streak and for Sinvicta luck. This is the quintessential non-Sinvicta luck run. Okay, I don't care about the heals. Seraphim, it would be an orbital, but I think I've proven that we don't need orbitals on this run. We get Gimpy again, which I don't actually care about. Alright, well, we got it anyway. Alright, so we can take blank card, and we can Purrthro rune this till our heart's content and get exactly the items that we want. I'm not going to subject you to that. I am going to take this Red Heart HP, though. Only reason why I'm doing that is because we know that we're going to get guaranteed deals with the devil thanks to Goathead for the rest of this run. Now, on the victory lap, it is going to remove that. But for right now, I feel comfortable doing that. And we can still go after Boss Rush, too. All right, we'll take the negative. Let's wait and see what we have here first. Do we want to take anything here? Friend Zone, Sad Bombs, Plan C, and the Straw. This is pretty bad. I'm going to... Ooh, if I open this, the Boss Rush is going to start. Speedball. The Eye Agreed, Curse the Tower, and Mom's Coin Purse. Yeah. Yeah. No. I think we just head on down. Yes, I could have broken the run there. There's two reasons why I didn't. First off, we don't need to do that. Secondly, I have to think about the amount of time that we're going to be on this run. And something could be said, because I've never gone for an ultimate victory lap run. I didn't mean to do that. I don't know if the items that we roll through here are going to be taken out of the pool on subsequent victory laps. I don't know. Again, this is in my thousands and thousands of hours of playing this game, I've never truly gone for an ultimate victory lap run. Guppy's head again. We may want to get rid of this just because we want to get rid of our red hearts. And then we can Purrthro rune this. We get Dead Cat again, man. And we can even get Mr. Me here, which I am going to take just so we can get rid of our red hearts again. And then we can Purrthro rune this. We get Scapular, which is fantastic. I know, you freaked out. Why you use the Purrthro runes in Victo? Why? It's because we have that second one there. Don't worry about it. Don't even trip, man. Or woman. It's Christmas. Merry Christmas, everyone. I hope you're enjoying this run, because I am a whole lot. And I'm going to be enjoying it a lot more, too, if we get Death's Touch. I'm going to start speeding things up here. Just because we don't need to... We really don't need to linger a whole lot. Black Rune, I would love to take Black Rune. Just for the chance to have a bunch of stat-ups. But... You know, we're at a certain point, we're going to reach critical mass for damage. We're going to reach a point where we cannot possibly do any more damage than we're doing. Have we hit that point yet? No, we haven't, which is why I'm going back to look through golden chests. But we're going to be hitting that soon because our fly damage is so freaking high. And you couple that with the fact that we're firing at a soy milk rate. We're unstoppable. This is unstoppable. As Isaac, this is unstoppable. So what I'm going to do, this is what I'm going to do. So I'm just going to plan this out now. What I'll do is I'll go through this victory lap. I'll do one more victory lap. And then if we turn into the loss there, which I believe that happens on the third run, I will end the video there for part one. That way everyone has something to watch tomorrow. See how that goes. Sad Bombs don't really need it. Bobby Bombs don't really want it. I'm not going to go fight Hush again. I've already explained this. I'm not fighting the extra bosses right now. While yes, we are unstoppable, it does not serve any purpose. So we're gonna speed things up here. Ooh, man. This could be good. We don't need the soul. Growth hormones is so good. So is Jesus juice too. I'm not gonna be greedy. I'm gonna take the damage when I can. Thank you, charge, baby. I'm really hoping that we get Libra. Blue Baby's only friend, doesn't really matter to us here. Another Burkano rune, man. The rich get richer, that's for sure. And we are super rich right now. As far as stats are concerned. He still hit that shot, huh? I'm gonna roll this library one more time. 10 bombs for boom, I'll take it. Not that we need bombs, of course, but again, we've got 99 more of these to go. All right, and I have no idea how much harder it's going to get. But right now, when things are nice and easy, I think we should take a little bit of time here to explore what we can and can't do on this run. At the same time, trying to keep everything in perspective. What is going on? Oh, we have rainbow tears. Where did we get the rainbow worm from? I didn't even notice it. Oh, whatever. Whatever, it's festive. It's not exactly Christmas themed, but... Can part one get 2,000 likes or more? Can we get 2,000 likes or more on the entire victory lap run? Will we actually die? These questions and more next time. All right, let's go fight the lamb. Oh God, Nun's habit. All right, we'll take it. So I'm gonna. That's the plan to rehash, everyone. I'm going to do this run and then do one more run for the third one. And that one I'm gonna fly right through, quite literally. And then see if we turn into the lost. And then that's where I'll end the video. Regardless if we turn into the lost or not, on the third lap, I'm gonna end the video there because I already hear people calling my name. Black Lotus, we don't really need it. Come on, game. You know you want to give me Deadeye or I'll take Penny Sack just because we have money equals power and monkey equals power. Come on, game. You know you want to give me the Deadeye, the thing that I've been waiting for. Come on now. Roid Rage again. Doesn't do anything for us, but... Box. What's in the box? Hey, we start right back from square one. Get the golden horseshoe again. All right. I can dig it. I can definitely dig it. Two of diamonds. I could have maxed that out and gotten us like 99 cents, but nah. Okay, Perthro gives us nothing again. I'm gonna touch this just to get it out of our inventory, out of the loot table and such. Heard a chest drop over there. Thanks to Guppy's tail. We did turn into the mom. We have mom's knife, but it's not mom's knife. Mom's knife. Mom's bottle of pills. Again, I'm touching it just to get it out of the loot table. And remember, we have chaos as well, so our loot tables are going to be a little bit wonky. Yeah, hey, lamb, remember us? Well, we've gotten even stronger. Oh, you know it. One more time. Here we go. Book of Shadows. I'm gonna take the Book of Shadows just so we can get Bookworm Transformation. And then we'll. I'm not gonna worry about rerolling that. Ooh. Okay. So they took away soy milk. Okay. So we lost soy milk here. Things just got a little bit more iffy. Tammy's head, how you doing? Okay, so that changes things here, because without soy milk, a lot of our advantages are gone. We still have chaos, though. Cricket's head. Absolutely must have that. So now our number one item that we're looking for is soy milk. Is it clubs? No, thank you. Okay, so that definitely puts the brake on this run as far as the brakes on this run as far as like making this one quick. I am error here. Now what I'm thinking of is instead of searching for like the perfect item, what we need to be searching for is how do we skip floors? Or should we even skip floors? Because if they took away soy milk was way, way back in our loot table. I don't know if it's determined randomly on what gets taken away or not. Very happy to see Goathead again. That at least guarantees us that we're going to get Devil Deals once again for this run. Chaos should still be a thing. I mean, I know it is because we just got Goathead from a boss. Okay, so this is what we're looking at here. So this is absolutely a perthrowable room. Synth oil is not bad. Synth oil would give us spun, I think. Yeah, okay. Penny sack again. Alright, so we got spun. Now we're looking at utilizing Maw of the Void more now. Mr. Mega, we don't really need it. I could roll it, but okay, we get an Algis Rune, which is good for protection, not that we need it. I mean, we still, despite me saying that we lost a lot of our advantages, which we definitely did, we're still strong. We are arguably much weaker than we were, but that's not like, you're talking about the difference of like a god level strength to like a demigod level strength. Like we're still going to absolutely smoke this entire run. This does have me worried for the loss though. Maybe I should have bought that raw liver. I will take more growth hormones. Okay, neither one of these really tickles my fancy. Halo of Flies and Rune Bag. We already have Rune Bag. I wouldn't mind Halo of Flies, though. Halo of Flies does give us a little bit of protection. You know, do we take Blank Card Yara? I would be more inclined to take Blank Card Yara if we had Restock. If we had Restock, then I would almost certainly take it. Mama Mega, I don't really care about. Okay, we get the 9-volt again. That's going to give us another charge on our spacebar item. Okay, we got nothing there. Okay. We're going to keep on going. I wish I had my Yara rune. All right, never mind. Didn't matter. I mean, look, you can't really complain about what's happened on this run. It's still a monster run. We just got so used to having soy milk that it does feel like a little bit of momentum has been lost. I didn't mean to do that. But make no mistake about it, we're still insanely powerful. Was it me or that troll bomb looked like it was moving a lot faster than normal? Oh, you know what? I think we lost money equals power. Yeah, we lost money equals power. Okay. AWAS, don't really care about that. We get the virus, which is going to be huge, of course. Mama Mega again. Dead Dove. I don't think we take either one of those. What was this? Was this Hoggles? No, it was. Let's see what's in our store here. Get Pyro, another Curse of the Tower. Book of Revelations. I mean, Book of Revelations. I have to think about the long term. At some point, I need to think about the long term here. You know, as the Lost, do I think that we have a better chance of winning, or at least of living, with blank card Yara? PhD would be really good here if we get a Tears Up pill. Balls of Steel is also very good. I don't want Guppy's Tail. We don't need it. We get Judas's Shadow. Okay. So, the obvious question... By the way, I just realized that they took away 9 lives, too. That second 9 lives. We have 9 lives, and we have Judas's Shadow. And then we also have Guppy's Collar. And then we just got the 1-up. So, yeah. So now we have to start thinking about, do we turn into Black Judas? I think the answer is obviously no. You save Judas's Shadow. You save Judas's Shadow for when you turn into the Lost. Now, it is possible that the game would take Judas's Shadow away from us. You know, so something could be said that we may want to turn into Black Judas before we do this, but if we're going to turn into the Lost after this run anyway, then that's kind of a moot point. Dad's Key. Don't really need Dad's Key. Let's see what's in the Devil Deal first. All right, it's going to be Chad. Of course, we don't care about Chad. Birth Row, we get Mom's Eye and Mom's Box. Neither one really that great for us. So I'm going to look for... I'm going to get one more full charge and roll. This could be a library. It is not. The soul. I will take the soul this time around. Okay. So let's roll this Devil Deal here. The big factor is still chaos. The fact that we still have chaos gives me hope that we can still get what we want. And we're not looking for much here. Tears upgrade would definitely be nice. I should bomb the dresser here. Bomb it for pills, see what we get. Bad gas, and I can see forever. Oh, yeah. It feels like our our tears rate is a lot slower than just 18. I mean, 18 is really bad. An 18 tier delay is quite bad. Tears up. There we go. That's what we're talking about. That. We got another full charge there. It's good. Do not want little baggy. We get the eye agreed once again. Throw. Yeah, they still want it. Man, they really want us to have Mr. Mega. Got a luck upgrade there. We get Book of Revelations again. Alright, I'm going to take Book of Revelations to get out of the freaking... so I stop seeing it. Roll this shop. Again, money doesn't really matter anymore because we don't have money equals power at the time. I mean, the safety pin doesn't give you a tears up. It gives you a shot speed up. Anarchist Cookbook and Mr. Boom, we don't really need either. Yeah, so I think... where our salvation lies, as far as our tiers are concerned, will be those tiers up pills that we got, the blue and the brown one, I think. So picking up PhD was certainly the right choice. Now we just have to see it through to fruition. Also notice that we did lose the compass. So I think we got to start. We have to start thinking about taking Blank Card Yera if we get a chance to get it, because they're going to continue to take more and more items from us. Perks is not bad. Not what we want. Okay. Power pill. Get cube meat. I'm fine with that. Now, it's very likely that we don't have Gnawed Leaf anymore. Lost power pills again. And Mr. Mega yet again. Okay. I still feel confident. Let's see. I don't think we have Gnawed Leaf. I'm pretty sure we don't. Yeah, so they took away Gnawed Leaf as well. One makes you small, and the other one's Power Pill. No, thank you. Something for Ansa's rune there. Okay, matchbook is fine. We're still looking for more here. Alright, so we can bomb our way, we save ourselves two keys here, and I think I'm fine with that. Especially after I've seen what's in here. And the cursed room. Nothing. Okay. Alright. Chaos. I could use a solid here. Honestly, all I want is soy milk back. If I could choose one item we can get out of everything else right now in the world, I would take soy milk. I want soy milk back. We had such a perfect soy milk run going. We're not gonna let the game Grinch this run up. Forever. What's the other one? Power pill. I'm kind of sad that we didn't get a chance to use the soy milk combo that we had as the lost. Berry bombs, don't really need them right now. Butt bombs, no thank you. Yeah, what's with all the bombs though? Game. Yeah, but seriously, like, we don't need bomb items? Tempted to take Mom's Knife, but I'm not going to. Lots of books. More butt bombs. And the Bible. Well, I'm only touching the Bible to get it out of the item pool here. Scatter bombs. Okay. So we get a Red Heart upgrade here. There's also Ansa's. Might as well use the Ansa's rune. Even though I know that we were close to the end. The Perthro rune is still valid. Like, we still need the Perthro rune. Because we need to make the big time plays happen as far as, like, the items are concerned. I'm going to keep touching these books to get them out. Because if we do spawn a late game library, that's more books that we don't have to worry about rolling through. So let's see what's in here. A lot of nothing and lucky rock. Okay. Judgment. We don't really care about judgment. Now, in order for me to be compelled to do boss rush, yeah, we have Nun's Habit. Completely forgot we had Nun's Habit. In order for me to truly be compelled to feel like I needed boss rush, we would need to see, like, S-tier items in there. or roll into them. But Mom's is not an S tier item. Guppy's head is an it's like a A tier item. No. Okay, we'll head on down here. Moving a lot slower than since the last time we were here, Mom. Taking soy milk really did kill the momentum of this run. But it's not going to kill the run. I'll just rune. As you recall me earlier saying that, normally when I've done victory laps before, you are pretty much guaranteed to see the same items that you had at an earlier point in the run. So I'm not worried about the fact that we don't have soy milk right now, because I have full confidence that we're going to see it again. And when we do, it's going to be glorious. Thank you, Death's Touch, for the shot speed upgrade. Or Death's list, I should say. No. All right, that's a full clear, by the way. In case if anyone was wondering whether or not we still have the ability, even on a god-like run like this, to not find the right way to go, the answer is yes. We still do. That will always... There's not a whole lot of guaranteed truths in this world. That's certainly one of them. We will always go in the wrong direction. Don't you worry about that. Okay, this could be a library. It's a one room. I'm not re-rolling. There's no way. Not in a million years. Not if you paid me to do it. More shot speed's great. The faster our tiers can get to the target, the faster they can spawn flies, the more damage that we do. Hoggles. Tears up. Tears up. Tears up. No tears up. Daddy long legs. Daddy dead. Mr. Dolly gives us tears up finally. Skeleton key gives us 99 cents. I don't really want. And we can take glitter bombs just to get it again out of the item pool. For now, anyway. So we'll head on down. But I'm a little bit surprised that we haven't seen one of the premier stat items yet. I had the ability to take Mom's knife, and I seriously considered it after seeing that we don't have soy milk anymore. Because the thing about Mom's knife is that Mom's knife damage will remain constant. So it doesn't matter if we see raw stat ups or not, we would still have good stats. Wow, that's the fastest I think I've ever found Mom. Like, fastest ever, without having, like, the compass or something. Or an Emperor card. Don't want an Eternal Heart. Okay, we get a Forget Me Now, which I don't want. Yeah. I mean, if I really wanted to, I could go back and roll through those. I'm again being summoned downstairs. Told him to wait. I am hungry though. Ooh, that's the curved horn. And yeah, don't worry, curved horn. Daddy's coming back to get you. All right, so curved horn gives us a flat damage up. And that's a big time get for us. It would have been even better had we had soy milk, but I'm still gonna be somewhat salty about us losing soy milk, because that was something that we got really, really early. I don't think the game had to take it from us. It just decided to. Death's Touch gave us more range. By Death's Touch, I mean Death's List. Wow, we're on fire now. Find these. We even get a little chest. Sack of sack, sure, why not? Stanley's not gonna have a fun time with this fight. I mean, despite us not having soy milk, we're still doing buku damage. We're gonna head on down and head to the lamb here on lap 2. And once we complete lap 3, this will officially be the longest victory lap run I've done. Terracloth is something I do not want. Not right now, anyway. Tears up, you don't know me like that. I think our tears rate is capped, actually. Oh, yeah. I didn't have the Prothro room. I was like, excuse me? Did it re-roll into itself? What happened here? I'll try from below. It's kind of whatever. Double chest. Okay. Sacrificial altar, and we get sin robes. I am going to use sac altar here. We get the mark. We got the Leviathan transformation. I'm not entirely sure what we sacrifice, though. Oh, it's Charge Baby. Sorry, Charge Baby. Your contribution will be greatly missed. The credit card doesn't do anything for us. The mark, of course, is going to give us even more damage and more movement speed. Get the relic. I mean, essentially the run ends here, so getting extra items I don't think is going to do much. But you never know. We might be increasing the odds of us losing a good item here by taking more items, or we could be diluting it to where the item, maybe the game doesn't take away the good items that we want to keep. I'm not sure. Truthfully, I do not know how that works. All I know is that I know that a lot of people are going to be interested in seeing what happens tomorrow if we do turn into the Lost on this run, which I think we are. I'm going to use the Black Rune, but not in there because I don't want to lose the Prothro Rune. There we go. We have a 2.09 movements or shot speed. That's really good. Our shots are moving. Guppy's tail, keep going here. Now, Skinny on Mushroom doesn't do anything good for us because I'm pretty sure that we're already tears capped. The only other, this is what I will say. The only other item that I would consider taking as far as tears are concerned would be chocolate milk. Chocolate milk would allow me to pulse fire manually and thereby bypassing our tears rate. But outside of that or soy milk, we don't take anything. And contract from below, just killing it. Loki's horns. Don't really think we need Loki's horns, but I'm going to take it anyway. Get the box. Don't really need goat hoof. I think I'd prefer to have, what is this, explosive diarrhea? Yeah, I'd rather have my Prothro rune. No. Prothro rune. Thank you. And again, contract from below is just raking in the freaking chests, man. The gauze we don't really need. Let's roll these two bad boys here. We get the holy mantle! Well, that makes me feel slightly better about turning into the Lost on the next run if that does indeed happen. Caffeine pill, euthanasia I will take. So we get the holy mantle and close it out with a bang here. Now the question is, how do we start? I just got butter again. And yeah, we are the Lost. So the question is, what do we retain now? We retained Holy Mantle. So that's good. We still have Maw of the Void. We still have Blank Card. We still have 9 lives. And we still have Blank Card per throw. I'm going to take Deathless here, and that's where I'm going to stop it for now. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hopefully this is what you all wanted. Again, apologies for splitting the video up in two, but we're already at an hour and a half, and I have been yelled at for the last 30 minutes now. So Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy New Year, everyone. We'll pick up right where we left off tomorrow. Oh, man, can we get those 2,000 likes or more? Hey, that would be a nice Christmas present for me. I wouldn't expect it, but I would appreciate it. Thank you very much again. Happy Holidays, Merry Christmas, and as always, everyone, I will see you next time. Until then, so long, everybody.